Let's spice up our e-commerce store with some email marketing, SMS, and automation using Omnisend. Plus, we're going to spice it up a bit with some help of ChatGPT. So let's get started with this video right now. The system that we're going to use is called Omnisend, and we're going to use it to automate our e-commerce store with some SMS, some email marketing, and some push notifications. Now, they have a really generous free plan that you might want to check out. I'll leave the link in the description, and you're going to get access to all of this as of this video. Now, like I mentioned before, we're going to spice it up a bit with ChatGPT, which is an AI engine, and we're going to use it to help us bring our message closer to our clients and make it more interesting. Now, how do you get started? Well, we have to integrate Omnisend with one of our sites. It could be several types of sites that we can integrate with. In this case, I've integrated with WooCommerce, but it does integrate with other e-commerce stores. Now, it's super easy. Install the plugin, activate it, and you're good to go. You get access to the general settings, locks, and sync. So we get a tag setting for this specific site. I've already added mine. And we can do it, check opt-in setting if we like also. Now, once you have that set up, like I said, that's the hardest part, and basically it ain't even hard. You get access to Omnisend's dashboard. Now, in the beginning, you're gonna head on over to the goals, and this is where it's going to tell you things that it's going to suggest for you. I've already accomplished the goals, and you're gonna have a quick overview of everything that's going on. Now, we wanna get started with campaigns, okay? So in this case, we can go ahead and get started with a new campaign, and we have several settings available. We're gonna start on over with the email. Let's create an email for this. And like I said, we're gonna get some inspiration from ChatGPT AI. So first of all, we have the subject line. Now it's going to depend on the business that we have, what we want to use for the subject line. Now let's ask ChatGPT what we can do. And we can even go crazy and it'll give us some inspiration. Like say that this is a woman's barbershop and we need a subject line. Let's ask it. Okay, so I'm trying to get a little inspirational here, and I said, give me some interesting email subject lines for a woman's barbershop. So let's click enter, and let's see what we get. So instead of just writing your typical subject line that doesn't catch anyone's attention, well, we got some really, really interesting ones right here. So check this out. Look sharp, book your next cut at our woman's barbershop. Haircut and empowerment, experience a difference at our woman's barbershop, etc. So we can grab any one of these, and we can use it as inspiration. Now, like I said, I'm just getting a little bit crazy here with that, but you can use your own. A sender's name, we'll name her Barbara. All right, and the sender, I'll just keep mine. The pre-header, again, we'll ask some pre-headers. So let's say, give me some pre-headers. And here we go, and we're gonna get some pre-headers for the subject that we're talking about. Now, if you wanna sign up for ChatGPT, it's free as of this video also, so go ahead and use it. So let's grab the first one. I'm not gonna go in depth into each one of these. And let's go ahead and add it here. Campaign, I'll just say barber shop. Okay, language is English. If I'm using other languages, I can do so here and I can manage translations. Now I can auto post email campaigns to my Facebook page if I like. I'm not gonna do it now, but it is possible, okay? So we just started with this one and we're gonna get some recommended templates for this. Now I've already added my logos and the colors that I use. That's why you can see SaaS Master here. Now, we could see the email messages that there's available. For example, if we're gonna use this for weekly newsletter, I'll use the template, and it's gonna load up the builder. In this builder, again, I'll just make this logo smaller because it's just too big, and I can center it. So here we go, let's go ahead and center that. And again, we can change all of this. So I can change each one of these elements, remove them, add them, modify them, etc. And again, we can use ChatGPT to make it more interesting. So give me some descriptions I can use on an email. Okay, let's click enter and boom, we're gonna get some descriptions here. And you can see it even gave me like these paraphrases where I can add my own shop name. So if it has a specific name, because I just told it what the business is for, I didn't actually tell it the business name. So it's just deciding where I should put that. So again, I'll just add something like this. Let's go here, replace that there. And it actually grabbed all of that. So I'll have to paste it. I'll just paste it here on the bar and then paste it here. And here we go. And I'll put it my shop name. I'll just say shop, all right? And again, we can use other type of elements. For example, quick add elements. I can add buttons, images, videos, etc. And just make this customized to what I need. In this case, I'm not gonna do it. I'm just gonna finish editing this one. but it's super easy to start your campaigns. In this case, I am not going to send this out right now. I can choose to. I'll send it to other subs, and I'll go to next step. I can send the test email if I like, but in this case, I'm going to exit because I don't want to send it out. Okay, so that's how easy it is to create a new campaign, and you can create it for different type of situations. Now, there's the automation section here for different type of situations. I created one for a cart abandonment and a welcome one. So, for example, if I go to my site right now, the one I'm testing, here we go. It just loaded, and boom, we got a pop-up. And this is just a pop-up to get subscribers and offer them a 10% off discount. Now, once I've installed the plugin and added this, it automatically added for me. So it's that easy. If I need to create a new workflow, I just do so here. And there's a different type of situations that I can choose from that help me out. For example, abandoned cart, I already created one. Order confirmation, abandoned cart value split, cross sales, welcome, shipping confirmation, order follow-up. A lot of flows that we can use that are pre-built. I'll just grab one of these, or order confirmation. So customize the workflow. And again, we're gonna get access to the workflow. And this is where some automation comes into play. And it's super easy to use. I mean, there's nothing crazy about it. So for example, there's a trigger, which is going to trigger this specific workflow and the exit condition. If we wanna add some email, SMS, push notifications, we can do so in here. For example, I can add it here. So along with that, I can add a push notification. I'll connect the app to this. I can create a delay. So for example, I'll add the push notification after a delay. So I'll delay 4 and I'll say, minutes. I'll say 2 minutes. Here we go. And then we're gonna trigger the push notification. So after 2 minutes, there's a push notification. Again, we can add tag to contact, split, and A/B testing to test which one works better depending on the results that you are going to get. And that's why you're gonna get the stats for each one of these workflows to see what works best. So it's super easy, okay? Let's save and close this. And you can have all your automations right here. Again, add more workflows if you want. You can see the enabled and disabled. There's also the forms section. So in this section, we can create a new one. Again, there's several templates available that you can get started. So for example, International Women's Day. We're actually talking about a woman's barbershop, so let's use this. So let's ask ChatGPT to help us with this. So let's say, okay, so I'm just telling it, give me a header message based on my business, which we talked about previously in ChatGPT, and this. So let's see how it mixes it up and what results we're going to get. Here we go. I'm gonna tell it, give me more. Okay, and now we're gonna get more. And see how it tied it together. So it's talking about celebrating International Women's Day, and then says, treat yourself to a haircut at our women's barbershop. And again, happy International Women's Day. Treat yourself to a haircut at our women's barbershop. Celebrate the power of women with a fresh haircut at our women's barbershop, etc. And it's tying that message based on what we're talking about. I mean, that's what's really nice about ChatGPT, that it's gonna help us combine the power of Omnisend with a power of a great message to transfer that to our clients or possible clients. And again, we can change it to this, for example, this coupon code, again, with ChatGPT, we can go ahead and tell it, rewrite to make it more fun, all right? And let's try this. Guess what? There's a coupon with your name on it. Get a 10% off now. See how I made it a little bit more fun? So it's just not direct. There's a 10% off coupon code waiting for you. So it's just like plain. But in this case, it's like, it made it fun, okay? It made it interesting. So we can use that instead of what we have right now. So it spices it up a bit more. And again, we have the builder on the left. We can ask for email, legal consent, phone numbers, input, etc. Add some columns to divide this and make it look really nice. Again, you have the behavior for this, the audience segment, scheduling, display, the targeting, visibility, and frequency. And we can go ahead and enable this. For now, I'm not going to enable that. There's the audience. So again, here, this is where all your contacts are going to be. We can segment them via tags or other situations. So you can see segment. I've created this segment, which is subs, and I've added one contact. I can create more segments based on subscription status, the tag, viewed page, birthday. So for example, viewed page, if they view a specific product, then I can tag them with a certain tag so I can later use that for email automation. Birthday, city, consent, there's a lot of segments that we can use to make this more useful, okay? Pre-built segments that we can use. Again, they have templates available that we can start using. customer breakdown. So once you start using this customer breakdowns, there's the import, export, and then we have the tags. And we also have the reports. For example, there's the standard reports, there's the workflows, there's the forms, there's the advanced section, and the deliverability. Okay, so there's other type of situations here. For example, sender warmups. If you have more than 20K contacts, that's gonna be available. Email list hygiene, if you wanna get quality email lists, so make sure that they are working. Sender domain, set that up. So don't use your standard Gmail or something like that. Use your own custom domain. And you can add custom sender domain here. Sender email addresses, again, add them here. So in this case, I haven't set that up because this is just for demo purposes. But that is Omnisend. If you wanna check it out, use the link in the description. I'll leave the link to Omnisend, ChatGPT, and check it out. So that's a wrap.